Now I present the third case. Here is a large, dominantly solid nodule. The cystic content is around 20 or 25%, so dominantly solid nodule. I raise your attention to three quite large hyperechoic granules. One is located here, the second is here, and the third can be seen here. I restart the video from the start, yes. So here, there, and here in the dorsal part. So these three or four granules are much larger and much brighter if we correspond them to, for example, these smaller granules. These are, these pale lines and granules correspond to backfall figures, but this and the other, which we can see, are not clearly backfall figures. Okay, a very tiny cystic area we can see here, but I cannot exclude the possibility on this ultrasound presentation that this nodule has not only backfall figures, but also we should consider the presence of microcalcification in such quite larger echogenic figures. If we go further with this video, we can see that this patient had several other partially cystic nodules, and if we consider this entire presentation of the thyroid, it is a fact which should us calm down regarding the larger lesion in the nodule. It is a reasonable assumption that this patient had 6 to 10 discrete cystic lesions, partially cystic lesions, and this was only the largest one which was presented here and which we can see again here. So if we see only this nodule, we had much more concern compared with the situation if we analyze the entire thyroid. So it is very likely that these hyperechoic figures in question are really not microcalcifications. Not an absolute proof, but the presence of other cystic lesions decreases the likelihood that these figures are microcalcifications. Here in the left lobe, or in the isthmic part of the thyroid, we can see the characteristic presentation of backwall figures. These are all located dorsal to cystic areas. This presentation should not cause concern. And we can also see echogenic granules within this lesion, but the simultaneous presence of echogenic granules and lines with a similar echogenicity, similar brightness, should not cause concern. Granule, but lines prevail over granule, and more importantly, these figures are similarly bright. The left lobe also had several cystic or partially cystic lesions. So much more, finally, this is a predominantly solid nodule. The echogenicity is moderately hypoechoic. According to all thyroids, this nodule is a candidate for cytology because exceeds 2 cm in maximal diameter. Some concerns we have about these figures, but irrespectively of our concern, this nodule has to be aspirated. So this was our